guys, so today I'm going to show you all the review on the Smoky palette from Forever 21. I'm going to show you all kind of like my first impression on this. I actually have it all on right now, but in this look you're gonna see what colors I use, and you're also going to kind of hear my thoughts on what I think about the product throughout the whole video. So if you want to see what my thoughts are on this product, just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with putting this color all over my lid. I'm just taking a fluffy brush because it doesn't really matter, you know, where I put it, because it's just gonna go all over my eyelid. So this color is almost the exact same color as my skin, so it doesn't look like a big difference. So I am gonna take this lighter tone right here. I'm just gonna use my finger and I'm gonna kind of try and place that in like the center part of my entire eyelid. Okay, so that just adds a little bit more shine to it. Next, I'm gonna take this kind of coppery brown color, and I'm gonna take a little bit of that on just kind of like this dome-shaped brush, and just start sweeping it on my right there. So it is a little bit deeper than I was expecting. So I'm gonna put a little bit over here. So I'm just gonna kind of rub off whatever is left on my brush so I can just work with the color I have in my crease right now. It's not too much, but if I put a little bit more, it might be too intense. So I'm just working the color into this other eye. I did put a little bit more on my brush, especially work this outer corner area. And so I'm gonna go back with that second color we used, this really light champagne color. I'm gonna mix it with the white because I want it to be a little bit more contrasting, like right here, like right in the center of my eyelid. So I'm just gonna kind of pop this color right here, and then I'm gonna do the same thing to the other eye. Then for my inner tear duct area, I'm gonna take kind of another rounded stiff dome brush, and I'm gonna take the white color, and then if I feel like I need some shimmer in there, I'll take the color right next to it. But I think this color would be perfecto. So I'm just gonna pop this white color in there. It's coming out a little peachy. So far the colors have been very easily blended. The darker color was a little bit harder to, or not harder, but it was a little bit more opaque than I thought it was gonna be. I just thought it was gonna be a lot sheer. The lighter colors, the two champagne colors I used, those were definitely lighter. It's not like a harsh white, it's like a very like light white. Like you can almost, like it's very transparent, like you can't really see it. So I'm gonna go in with that shimmer color just a tiny bit because I do like a little bit, like I want it to look a little bit brighter in there. Hopefully this does it. Okay, and for your lower lash line you can do whatever. I'm gonna take this flat brush like this, and I'm gonna take that same color we put in our crease, which is this one right here. I'm gonna take that color and I'm gonna put it right next to my lash line. I just take it down a little bit further than you normally would. And then I'm gonna take the color right next to it, which is a little bit darker. I'm gonna place that only on the outer half of my lower lash line, and then I'm also gonna place it really close to my lash line. And it's just gonna give it an even more smoked out look. And then we're gonna do the same thing to this side. So this palette does come with an eyeliner, so I'm just gonna use this on the lower lash line. And for being a pencil, I like it. It's very soft, and with just going back and forth a couple times, not pressing too hard, it's definitely leaving some color there. Then I'm gonna do the same thing to the lower lash line on this side, but it's leaving a definitely, like, I don't wanna say it comes off as black. I think it's definitely buildable, but I think it definitely comes off as like a dark gray almost, if you rub it just like once or twice. But as you go back and forth over it, it just gets a little bit darker. I'm going over the eyeliner, and it's just gonna help make a more smoky effect to it. Not blending it down too much, it's kind of just helping it set in there. Well, I guess I can attempt to use this as an eyeliner. Let me get my sharpener. I'm just really terrible at using eyeliners as, you know, like pencils, as used, like actually drawing it on, but we'll see how this goes. So I'm gonna sharpen it because you need a sharpened pencil for this. Okay, I got it pretty sharpened. I think it's decently amount sharpened. Okay, so I was gonna do my eyeliner, it kind of started on this side. I was gonna do it with this pencil, but it's a little bit too rough. Like, it's perfect for smaller surfaces, but once it's like something bigger like this, it's not the best eyeliner. I'm just gonna use my Maybelline, what is this? The, it's just like the little gel eyeliners that they have in the little pots. I'm gonna use this. I'm gonna line my upper lash line on both eyes, and I will come back. So this is the finished look. So thank you all so much for watching this video. I hope you all like kind of like this, what is it, first impression type of video. Now I'm here to tell you all what I think about it after having it for a couple weeks and trying it and using the colors and playing around with it. So my now review is that I really do like the product. I think it is an amazing product. I think the only down thing I don't like is that some of the colors seem to be more opaque than others, but that's kind of with all eyeshadow companies, that kind of tends to happen. Some of their colors are a little bit more stronger and some of them are just a little bit more weaker. I also am not a fan whatsoever of the white color. It just turns out to be almost like this very light sheen. So I wish that would have been definitely like a more highlighting kind of color. But you know, all the other colors are very, very good. I haven't really played around with the brush, but I have played around with the eyeliner a couple times. And for the most part, I really do like it. I think it is just a nice consistency. I wouldn't necessarily use it to like do a winged eyeliner or anything like that. But for the staying power of it being, you know, part of this palette, I think it is definitely a very good, deal. It gets very messy around here because the colors are, they're not like so compactly pressed, I guess. And so they're like, there's a mess everywhere on my palette, but I kind of tried to clean it up a little bit. So now I'm going to zoom you all into the colors and what they look like. But those are the colors it comes with, and like I said, it comes with the eyeliner and it comes with this little brush. That's one side of the brush and the other side is a sponge applicator. And I like this little window too. It's kind of cool because then you can like see when it's like stored away, you can like definitely see all the colors. So thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoyed this kind of video. If you guys have any questions about this palette, you can find it on the Forever 20 website, I'm pretty sure, and like any Forever 21 store. If I find it on the website, I'll just link it down below. Besides that, I really do recommend this product. So yeah, I will talk to you on the next video. Bye.
My Google Glass. So I filmed that yesterday. No, I filmed my film. No, because I filmed one
it's
that
still recording.
Oh.
It
kind of comes off as a smudge in the nose.
Okay. I'm zooming into the palette.
Oh. You're gonna be my zoomer?
Oh, what is that reflection? It's a horrible reflection. Let me see if I can block it with my head. Oh, look, I blocked it with my head.
You can also find it at any Forever 21 store, I guess.